So look at this. Soggy Ballers on the Orion side, Nightmarish on the Devager side with a Siren Strand pick. So considering Siren Strand, what are we expecting a band here? Are we thinking Imani?
I mean, looking at the teams, I feel like with Sirens, a team at ban?
Yeah, it is
okay,
a team at
from ban. Soggy Ballers. I feel like that's a good choice because on Sirens, it's all about the fight over D. So having a range that can just be poking a lot from far away, it's really good to get rid of that early.
Yeah, Tiamat has constantly just been super oppressive in almost every scenario where she literally just is the best range in the game right now. Super high consistent damage, auto lock rockets that do like crazy damage when they hit, crazy AoE damage with certain talents. It's just she's incredibly oppressive and so free as far as damage goes. So I'm not at all surprised that this is the ban.
Neither. And as well, like with Sirens, it's not as openly ranged as Sanctums, but the thing with Sirens is D is so crucial to hold. It's the only neutral point on that map. So if you have that, you're always going to be a power rotation above the other team. The Zenobia ban? I have just schooled them and they didn't listen.
What is going on? We just had this long discussion about Zenobia. And, I mean, she's not going to be in the game at the very least. I don't know why you would prioritize banning a Zenobia. Maybe they just don't have a preference as to what is being banned. I assume that the ban mindset is probably a little different because we're allowing mirrors in this tournament. So it's kind of like just, I don't know. It seems like they're not really scared of Imani being available because both teams can just pick Imani. It's not like you're locked out of it. But I never would have seen a Zenobia ban. Maybe there's something that Nightmarish know about Soggy Ballers. Like, do Soggy Ballers, you think, have a good Zenobia player and they just don't want to mess with that right now?
That'd be my only guess. I know Soggy Ballers. Maybe one of them plays Zenobia, and I don't think they're the world's greatest Zenobia by any means. I'm looking at the teams here, and I'm looking at Nightmarish. I don't know any of these people, so this is going to be a first time viewing for me. And maybe they do know something about the Zeno ban.
Yeah,
but I think that is absolutely, absolutely crazy. You're banning Zenobia.
It's definitely unexpected. And especially for round one of the entire tournament, right? Like,
yeah.
Definitely we're not seeing that at all. Round one, first game. So
this
I would
is why you don't look at the community tier list. Do not look at that.
It's slandering the thoughts of the overall general public. I mean, it's valid, but also like, oof. So what do we? Honestly, Orion side, what do you think they should kind of show here? I kind of say the thought of picking Imani first, but the more I think about it, if you show your Imani card early, it's a lot easier to actually deal with her because then you can actually prioritize just picking counters against her, right? If we're allowing mirrors, it's not like you're locked out of certain people. So, you know, if someone picks Imani on the Orion side here, we could see a Trip, we could see a Wu, we could see, I mean, probably like, I don't know, a Voden. But it does look like they are picking their first character now. Let's see what it is here. I feel like safety, yep, with a Sven. So the Sven being
safety
hovered
with a Sven
at the safety
is
with a Sven.
100% based. I mean, having that jump pad, you're eliminating the possibility of wasting stamina having to go through hallway. You know what I mean?
Yep.
You're eliminating that. And the Trip. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, the Trip just can't do anything anymore with the Sven. Nah, it's not gonna work.
I know that you have a very subjective opinion of Trip. I know that you believe that she's actually the worst assassin in the game right now. And I would love you to dive more into that if she actually does end up getting locked in. Because with the
100%.
With the grayscale that she currently is right now, it does just mean that she's being hovered, I believe. She's not actually been confirmed locked in yet. So tell me your opinion on Trip right now.
All right, I'm gonna take you guys to the private server where Trip was still mediocre, but she, if you guys play Trip or anything, you know her LMB upgrade, Power Surge, gives you a damage boost.
Yeah.
It used to give you damage and speed.
It is locked in.
Okay, let me cook. So, for new players, if you went Power Surge, you were getting a damage boost at level 1, which could go up to 25% if you hit them 5 times, and you were getting plus 25% move speed if you hit them 5 times. So your means you're getting a damage boost, and if someone shows up, you have a movement speed boost to get away. Free escape. That has now been split into 2 upgrades. Mm-hmm. So you're either getting a damage boost with no escape, so if you're new or you're just not very experienced, you can die easier, and you're missing out. Either you have to take that up, you have to use 2 skill upgrades to get the movement speed, and then you're missing out on crack armor that you can get, so your kill pressure is a lot worse early game.
Okay.
And on top of that, her kick doesn't stun anymore, which for her was a great way to secure kills. I mean, her kick is kind of her kill confirm.
Yeah. It does technically still stun on the tier 2, the beneficial kickbacks, but it stuns if they hit in from the back. It's a launch. Mm-hmm. So,
which I think a lot of the time people who are running from Trip usually have backup, or usually are smart enough to turn around and not get hit in the back. I mean, that's what I do. I keep flicking backwards. And the thing also, her damage, her primary, like her basic attack damage was reduced by, I think it's either 10% or like 20% roughly. It's a lot of damage that's gone. She's just not as good as she used to be. And even when she used to be good, she still wasn't the best. I stand by that the assassin list goes Kajir, Wu, Taito, Trip. That's what I stand by.
That is
right now.
That is quite the take. And I mean, there are points that I do agree with you, that I do think that she definitely has been toned back as far as like the immediate burst potential. I do think that she can still perform somewhat solidly in the right situation. But we're gonna move on from that. They've locked in Imani on the Nightmarish side
Imani
as well.
And Imani, so the double. Yeah.
Go ahead. I agree.
The double Imani pick is interesting here. That's going to be... So this is just going to literally be hold D open and let your Imani shoot them. That's going to be very, very good to see. That's going to be boring to see, to be honest. Imani is so boring. Such a boring character.
I kind of agree, but at the same time, I'm just not at all surprised. Considering that we're allowing mirrors, it's not like you're forcing Imani to only be stuck on one team. And Imani is very, very good on Siren. She's good on every map. She has stronger ones and weaker ones, as does every character. But Imani just is... She's good in almost every situation, just because she's so long range. She can constantly apply that pressure if she finds a good, you know, position. And like you said, opening up creatures on midpoint, opening creatures, or rather her team opening creatures on D, on C, or its mirror side, and just shooting from afar. She does that super well going into Clash, where, you know, you can stand all the way back, like right next to your guardian, and still shoot the D creature in the middle from your window. It's not at all surprising. The Paco is a very solid choice as well, in my opinion, for Soggy Ballers. Just a lot of AoE potential damage with the constant application of freeze. He's got great upgrades that he can invest in early that apply even additional freeze in CC, like the Snowball Days. I know you're a big fan of the Snowball Days. And just overall being a big damage sponge, you know, the single target lockdown, the AoE potential with constant application of debuffs. It doesn't take a lot of rocket science to figure out why Paco is a good pick. So what do you think is the answer for Nightmarish right now?
Nightmarish, okay. Soggy Ballers are... Thing is, Paco isn't a character until level 3. And Sven doesn't get... Sven's good at the early game, but he isn't extremely potent until he gets Absorption Matrix. So I think what they need is they're going to need a curse here, because all of, like, Paco and Sven, if you curse them, they've got nothing. So I'm thinking maybe an Oru could be interesting to see here. Oru's actually not that bad on Sirens. Or even just a Paco as well. I feel like Paco on Paco can't be fine. Hey, what did I say?
A Paco hover so far. And a woo pick. Okay, so a woo kind of... Yeah, woo kind of to consider against the Mani, and it is officially locked in now. So, yeah. You called that with the Paco. Just the additional, like, CC. I mean, everything that I said about the Soggy Ballers Paco, you can apply the same exact thing to Nightmarish. Mm-hmm. The woo pick is... The woo pick is good as well. The tongue is no longer like super long range because we all know that that clash talent got altered slightly.
Thank God.
So no one is picking that anywhere. Oh, you actually like that it got changed. I haven't heard this yet. This is news to me. This is news to me.
Long tongue was the most broken ability in the game, an ability that allows you to pull someone from safety. And what is that?
I love you on cast so far right now. It is just a hover. It's not a...
Thank God. No. Oh my God, no, please.
Yeah, it couldn't be Sven, because Sven's already locked in.
That's Ezra. I know that's Ezra. What do you say? But yeah, Wu Long Tongue. Tongue is already a stupid ability. It still is. You can reset cooldowns.
Mm-hmm.
If someone's safe, you pull them from safety, boom, they're dead. You have 10 power. It's such a stupid ability. But Long Tongue made it so you could hit them almost from on the two ledges on Reef. You could almost hit them with the tongue from your side. I'm sorry, like, that is just not okay. And they nerfed Wu already, so that his damage is overall less, which, thank you, I appreciate that. He's still strong, but Long Tongue being removed and being changed is a saving grace.
I can't see the chat right now, but I feel like there are a lot of people that are currently thinking or saying, like, Wu removal of Long Tongue, like, broke his character. And I don't agree, but I do think that he's definitely a lot weaker. But at the same time, I feel like he kind of needed to be toned back a little bit, and I've seen a lot of Wu still perform super super well, but man, I have not heard the opinion that Wu Long Tongue was a good change yet. That is wild to me. So it is locked in. We have a Taito and a Zandora. Look at this. This is a very frontal team composition here with a lot of like dueling potential. I feel like the Paco, Zandora, and Taito are gonna be constantly like going in, getting a little bit of support from the lobs of Sven Flass. And then, you know, just the artillery from Imani.
I'll be honest. I do not see a... Thank you, called it. Thank you.
Yeah.
If I do not see a curse, thank you. If I... Bro, Zandi's focus, you put curse on that, she has not got focus.
Yep.
It's gone.
Yep.
Easy peasy.
I couldn't agree more. This was a great pick. Let's see. Spectator cam is in. We have Soggy Ballers on the Orin side, Nightmarish on the Devager side. And Right now, it looks like Soggy Ballers have control of D.
Looks like they do. Oh, Cyclops, good choice there, actually. Very good choice there.
You are a fan of the Cyclops wall on D?
I am indeed.
I don't know.
That's the best thing to put there.
I feel like it doesn't provide that much benefit. You know, like, the wall itself is not really blocking that much because it's on the opposite perch, right? It just kind of... not lets the enemy team come in and hold like that high ground.
I mean, you're forcing them to go through that. You're either going through the mid to jump pad up, or you're forcing them to go through that hallway. And it looks like they're going D, but Soggy Ballers are already over at E where the power is.
Yeah, they're going to quickly just take down D. The Cyclops.
And now C's going to collect, and that's just going to be either get a kill or C's going to collect, and that's going to be the first rampage taken by Soggy Ballers.
Yep, 150 on this first push.
Damn.
That is a big difference. Dean rotation never even came into play. Just we saw, they must have got some kills that we didn't see before we actually joined the game. Mm-hmm. So
we're still going in.
Yeah. Big push happening right now. Just doing a little bit of damage to the Bloomer as we're positioning to take on this first attack. Gren is vulnerable.
Nightmarish are there to defend the the wound, but they're not there to try and prevent the creature from getting low. I wonder if they'll save the creature or end up killing it outright.
I feel like
saving the creature or just give them 10 power.
I feel like they should save it, but it might die to degens. Oh, very, very close.
Oh, they saved it. Yep. Very close, but they're tied. He died.
Yeah.
Simply merry.
Yeah, it looks like a kill was taken on the retreat of the wound. The wound was secure, but they get an even power on killing the creature. And they summon an obelisk.
Yeah. What is that?
Just a little bit for the... Just a little bit for the memes and also maybe for the potential of experience.
The Infernal on D is an interesting choice here. They get direct access to the ship, which can be good for a quick rotation.
Yeah.
Or even if the other team rotates, they have direct access to get there fast.
Yeah, I do think that the Infernal on D is something that a lot of people don't consider that often, but it can be very clutch when it comes to making these backup rotations. I mean, we've already seen Soggy Ballers do it once. They could probably do it again. A little bit of damage here.
It's gonna go down from the pack with the back.
Oh, look at all this happening over here.
They're all split on the Woo stock, and okay, there's a 20 power difference now. Soggy Ballers are 2 power rotations up because they have D. That's just unfortunate for Nightmarish there.
So it looks like the two assassins were wanting to go and make it a potential play on the back line, but it looked like Soggy Ballers just had the answer. A little bit of damage here coming on to Sven. But they are quick to respond. Paco has to get on out of there.
I think the two assassins could have pulled that off if it had been at a different time.
But if you look on the map, we actually see that Wu is over there interrupting C. And if they don't answer, he could probably kill that. Tido or Trip is there as well.
They are both there. They went through airship. They're just counter pushing and going E. That's the thing, because if they can stop E, they're just going to have to be 19 power and just need to get one more kill.
I actually would have.
They just need one more kill.
And that kill might go on here. A little bit of damage going on. Star Shield required to be used. And they're running away, getting on out of there. I actually feel like. Ooh, nice little kill. Get a little 80 power. But it does get a kill in return. A little bit of more shield to block the initial impact damage. And, well, they're just keeping pressure here. Look at all the damage. Oru ult being used to make sure that they can get some kills and also escape. And just applying pressure to make sure that Soggy Ballers can't go for the second wound. Very, very smart. You know, you keep enemies in contact, they can't recover.
I mean, the longer this goes on, I think it'll actually favor... the longer this goes on, I feel like it will actually just keep favoring Soggy Ballers. Their team only gets better. Their team is not very good early game. And they're still pulling this off, so the further this goes and their characters get their power spikes, I feel like that'll just favor them even more.
Yep. And we can see right now, Soggy Ballers just, like, moving in on this F point, like, or sorry, E point. They can't even, right now Nightmarish can't even keep control of their own side of the map. They're trying to chase these kills, and Wu can't even confirm anything right now. They're going to chase.
And they get the pick.
Paco's super low, kind of out of there right now, but he does fall to the clap. And they're trying to return something here. Nightmarish now ahead by 10. But now Soggy Ballers is in their territory. Or sorry.
Soggy Ballers takes down the trip. Nightmarish is in Soggy Ballers'
yes,
territory.
Yes, yes.
And low, mind you.
This one needs to get out now. Nice, nice hit. Nice snipe from the Imani to confirm that. This is an interesting play. A lot of constant fights happening here. Zendora going back in, going on this low health Oru right now.
Paku's invisible.
And that was Paku. You're right. That was weird. But Paku finding a kill there. Now we're going on to the F rotation.
Ooh,
good
the interrupt.
Interrupt
on F was huge. They need to kill F, and then they've got the rampage once again.
They have a second interrupt. Needs to be done now. There it goes. And the bloomer will fall, and 100 to 40 now. And we do have a current little glitch happening on the map right now, not showing the initial impact damage, but it does look like this might be close to an auto wound. It is only the third push of the game.
I think it will be an auto here. Yeah, this is probably an auto.
It might be close. I'm not certain. Yeah, ooh, very, very close. So they do have to push in. It looks like they're going to. They're going for it, or at least...
posturing themselves around D, I don't think they're gonna go for that. I think they're more just concerned about keeping D control, always being that par rotation up.
That's very true. End up holding D and also stopping them from holding F. You know, Nightmarish, we've seen this whole game just be on the back foot. Right now, big fight happening. Zendora and Paco.
The problem is one person on their team overextends, and then they're all kind of forced to either leave them or go in one by one, which is not the position you want to be in with the comp that Soggy Ballers is running.
And just look at this constant application of the area of effects that Zendora provides. Her aura is just allowing for the team to stay a lot longer. Any burst healing needed comes from Sven. Good focus from Sven to make sure that the trip doesn't get the kill there. She might escape. She does escape, but barely.
Patton doesn't, however.
And Paco went in to try and cover for her and ends up falling for it. Now they're moving back in. Oru forced to ult just to stay alive right now. The Zendora is just on him. Paco's stuck in the cave to recover just briefly. Very, very smart. Nice finish on the Oru here. And man, Nightmares just can't control their own base.
They need to reset. They need to all... I don't think they're calming quite like how they should be.
Good confirm off the Woo here. Trying to find a low health person, but they're still behind by 30 after all
unless
this.
Unless they can pick up Melon.
Nice.
They can pick up Melon. Now they need to posture towards C point here. They cannot let Soggy Ballers get that 20 power.
Yep, and Mimani has already moved onto the C point to defend it. She knows that they need to go there. Zendora.
Why are they going D?
That's a good question. This is not the right time. But we're seeing the fight here happen, trying to just get control of that. Maybe they're wanting to just take full control of it while they can.
I mean, they're going to have map control, and that will be Clash. So having D might actually be good there, unless Soggy Ballers hard rush it early and just manage to take it down. But it was I see where they're coming from with going D there.
Yep. Right now, we see that Soggy Ballers once again is holding the E point with the Obelisk spawned here. Wu doing his best to hold it and take it back, but they can't even do that. You know, they've got control of D point now, but if they don't even have their own side, it's only a matter of time before it turns. Paco getting chased away. But they need to reposition for Clash right now. That snowstorm's coming.
Clash?
That snowstorm's coming.
Oh no.
A little bit of fight happening over here. Chaos Quaff being
Sven
used
focus?
on the soul Wu doing his best, ends up falling, got super close to killing someone there, but overall just can't get there. Finally they are realizing that the clash has started, they're moving over. Nightmare still has control of
once.
D right now.
Not once did they think to go D, interesting.
Yeah, I think maybe perhaps they just didn't realize that it was Clash and they just never rotated fast enough. So now we see a reset happening where Soggy Ballers
are now going D.
Yep, now
interesting,
they're
moving so they're
in.
Going now. Nightmares have to defend this if they want to maintain their map control.
Mani Focus thing. Coming through, doing a bit of damage. The Cyclops is super low and waiting on that ledge. It teleports back. Look at that low health right now.
Ooh.
If they kill that, that'd be a good power.
Die. It might be dead here. Oh, it's a slither of HP, and the trip's going in, yeah. And the trip is going to finish that out. Oh, wait, that's their trip.
Yeah, that's their trip. Either way, it's very, very simple for them to move in and get this. They just have to get a little healthy. Taito's possibly going for it. This Wu just trying to find some bit of skirmishing on the side, but Soggy Ball is just grouped super well together.
And it goes down. Ezra's about to take it. I told you to trust in the Zandy. Zandy was cooking something.
I mean, they seem to be doing super well. We see these fights still happening. The midpoint has not been in control yet, but
so
it looks like it's
going
to go to Soggy Ballers.
Yeah. They're definitely going to be going for a wound here. They have the Zandy heals to get them healthy, and they've definitely got a focus or two ready.
Okay, you think that they're going to go for the end here with 100 to 80?
100%. 100%. I think they're... they're going to ball and they're going to go and get it.
Okay. Well, we see their positioning and full health right now. They're starting to move in. You called it. They're going aggressive. A little bit of damage happening. Nice application. Use the focus of Zendora to keep them healthy right now. Big, big damage numbers happening. It's just constant damage.
Guys, the shield's going to pop up. The shield pops up.
So much damage.
And Soggy Ballers take game one.
And we can actually just go right into the draft. It looks like it's going to be on Sanctum Falls. So what are you thinking, North?
Oh no, it's just gonna be... I'm expecting to see an Amani ban, probably, or a Tiamat ban from one of the teams. You know, that map is so ranged heavy. So if one of them aren't banned, I don't know, it's crazy to me if neither of them are banned.
Yeah, I kind of expect Sanctum Falls to be kind of the super heavy focus on Imani. So if she's not banned, then they're probably most definitely going to pick her again on both teams. And, well, we'll see what happens, right?
100%. It's going to be interesting. I kind of expect a jump pad in here at some point. Like, I'm expecting maybe a Voden or a Sven of some degree. I think the jump pad's so good on this map because it has those high grounds that you need to be able to access quickly.
Yeah, it's a combination of the jump pad and also just anything that really benefits your control on the C point. We all know that on Sanctum Falls, C point is kind of the most pivotal. There are two neutral points, but D is for the most part left alone throughout most of the game. And C ends up being the one where all the fights happen in those small hallways up into that big, not even really a big room, kind of a smallish room. And if you control that room, you basically have full control of the game. So this is what we sort of expect teams to be focused on, kind of the early game with the Imani, and then post-clash is more about... Post-clash is more about just having a little bit of AoE. And this is the map where we saw Ezreal kind of pop off in that one game. So we could also possibly think that. I mean, Nightmarish thought it was, you know, important to ban Zenobia. Maybe they still think that way.
Yeah, I agree. Sanctum's clash is about hallway. Once you get C, the enemy team have very limited ways of getting to you. If you can just stop them if they're pushing up hallway and you can stop them, it's guaranteed power for you and just guaranteed map control.
Yeah, 100%. But Imani is being banned. Nightmarish have just decided to take that away from both teams, which is very smart. You know, like I said, if Imani was going to be in the game, she was most definitely going to be on both teams because she's just super powerful. Oh! Nope. Okay, there we go. let's confirm that that actually is locked in before I continue, right? I do think that it is going to be definitely going to be Imani. And then Beckett is actually being picked
told on the to turn the music down a little bit.
Music is a little too loud. Okay, that's fine.
Yeah.
No worries. I can change that right now.
Let's turn that the two down. Rains being banned?
So locking down Imani and Beckett from being picked. That's a very, very interesting. I kind of figured that maybe perhaps a frontliner would have been kind of considered being banned here. But then again, since we're allowing mirrors, it's not like they're limited on the amount of characters. So vote and hover.
There's
right
that
now.
Jump pad.
Yep.
There's that jump pad we were saying. So we'll see. Well, I think it's smart that Nightmarish banned the Imani. I think it's because last game Simply was on the Imani and he was doing particularly a good job at finishing people and just constantly applying damage. So I think that's a smart move by them.
And this is just the first pick, which is important to remember. But yeah, Voden having quick, easy access, one upgrade dip to get a jump pad. Very easy, very, very often picked. It's actually almost no contest because the other side of the tree on his E is not very awful. Good, to say the least. But we will confirm if that is... We'll confirm if that actually is locked in. I can't imagine that it isn't. Lonan is very, very good. He always has been. A lot of people sleep on this character. He's got great damage. He almost never dies because he's super easy to escape with. The poison is super, super valuable. So this immediately forces Soggy Ballers to think, like, okay, what other options do we have as far as keeping people alive? Do we still pick a healer or do we just kind of focus more on our own personal survival with escapes and big health pools?
100%. I mean, there's an argument to be made that Voden is one of the best characters in the game. I would say he's probably one of the most survivable in the game. And I mean, for like new players, half of his kit can aim for you. You know, he's got the homing poison, his focus is a big AoE, he's got the clone. And if you take Companion's Boon, obviously, it's guaranteed shots. So I think Voden could be a good choice here, especially in hallway. Like, he's amazing in hallway for just dishing out damage. Oru.
We might see an Oru here.
Hmm.
We haven't really...
I don't know how I feel about that.
Yeah, we haven't really seen an Oru priority before, I don't think. It's definitely not something... Okay, so now we don't see anything. We don't know what's going on. Nightmarish is trying to make their mind here, but so far we've seen... Oh. What's going on, Banjax? That's not their pick first.
What is this?
I don't mind Amare first pick, but I'm pretty sure it's definitely supposed to be Nightmarish's first pick.
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah, it got moved. There we go.
Yeah, he is a new. It's a new drafting tool we're using. There's bound to be a couple little hiccups here and there, but it does look like a Margrave hover. So far, we've seen Voden, Oru, and Margrave. I mean, two of those three are very solid picks. You can never go wrong with the Margrave. Margrave is locked.
Margrave
in.
Is confirmed. Okay.
So yeah, this is. I mean, we've seen this before. Margrave's priority seems to be very, very strong. He's incredibly well-rounded, biggest health pool, lots of armor. He's got great engage potential. He's super mobile. Like, honestly, I'm never surprised to see a Margrave.
A Tiamat? Okay.
Tiamat hover right now. I mean, she's still open. I expected this. We're probably going to see Tiamats on both teams. Ooh!
Nosses! Oh, GG.
It's locked in!
Oh my god. Soggy Ball at Simply Mary. He's a card player. I know exactly who that is.
So they're locking in the Nosses second pick.
Interesting.
Real interesting showing decision. The Nosses card.
I think that might be... Melon's one of the players in Soggy Ballers. I think they're going to be on the team map. And I think... Kai's an interesting decision, you know?
It is. I am a fan of Nosses. I would never consider picking Nosses as your first two picks, because I think that he can be very easily countered. He's already been somewhat countered with a Margrave, you know? Like,
I think Nosses is just, he's been washed completely. He's been rinsed through, he's gutted completely since his former days.
Yeah. Nosses is a... Nosses requires a very, very specific team comp. And that team comp usually works a lot better in a blind pick, not a draft. I would pick Nosses much, much later, if at all. Well, we've got currently a Tiamat and a Mozu hover. I expected the Tiamat. Like I said, she's the strongest range in the game, and we're allowing mirrors. She's not banned. She's probably going to be on the team. And it is locked in as well as a Mozu.
What I'm saying here is one team is definitely going to be having a defensive way of playing. One team, I think, is going to be having a very offensive way of playing. Nightmarish have got the deflect. They've got the two deflects. They've got the health of a Margrave. And they've got the slows of, like, a Mozu. And that massive beam, you know. So if they're going to be... If they're going to have C control, especially during Clash and Hallway, they're going to have a much easier time controlling that. Whereas Soggy Ballers, the Zenobia, or the Ramsey even, and the Kai, they're definitely going for more offensive.
Yeah, so this looks like kind of a reiteration of the last team composition we saw, where it's going to be like these three, possibly these three melee, moving all together, maybe with a support with them. But still hovering Zenobia right now is a decision between the two of them. It could possibly be both. This is two picks right now.
Zenobia is an interesting choice here. She doesn't really do anything against what... Nightmarish have. Mozu could be a good shout, actually, if they're gonna go the Mozu.
You've seen
actually Sven pick.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. Sven, you know, he's overall the best support in the game. Good jump pad, easy access, good healing potential with Absorption Matrix, and you know, the constant ability to apply pressure with burns off of his LMB. Very, very simple to understand why he's a very strong character. Not confirmed locked in yet, but we also see a Wu being hovered. Soggy Ballers was the not the one that they had Wu on the last team. No, we see Ramsey again.
One team is distinctly going to be looking for rotations. They've got the speed boost on Soggy Ballers, the jump pad. They've got that survivability factor from the Ramsey and the debuffs. I think this is definitely going to be them just going to be going for rotates early.
Another Zendora hover.
Oh my god.
I was about to bring it up. I was about to say, if they lock in Ramsey here, do you think we would see Zendora as pick five? But now they're hovering. They've locked it in.
Yes.
The double Zendora. Two Zendora games in a row. This is very new to me.
Soggy Ballers, I knew they would do stuff like this. I knew it. It's going to be such a fun game to watch.
So the last time we saw Gnosis and Zendora on the same team was actually that big Ghost Reef match between Lil Guys and Illusion.
Illusion?
And Lil Guys really took us by surprise. I think they ended up winning that game, and it was kind of crazy. I saw things on Zendora Gnosis that I never thought I would actually see. So I definitely expect Poison to be picked somewhere on Nightmarish's team comp right now. They did hover Voden much earlier. I think they'll bring it back again. But no, they're opting for this trip. And a Griselma hover. Nope, just kidding.
Or a Woo?
It's a Woo.
Griselma would have been absolutely insane. And they lock in the trip and the Woo.
Okay. Hmm. So this is...
This comp has a lot of lockdown. A lot of lockdown.
It does.
But Soggy Ballers have a lot of means of getting out.
Yeah.
Is the thing.
So Nightmarish, I mean, this is very similar to the comp that we just saw them use, where they have the two assassins and a frontliner trying to make potential picks here, but we're returning.
And they lock in Taito?
Yeah, last pick Taito. We're seeing yet again kind of Soggy Ballers sticking to their roots of having these three skirmish heavy like forward melee attackers with a Sven to round two. Nightmarish versus Soggy Ballers. Nightmarish on Orion side, Soggy Ballers on Devager side.
Soggy Ballers already taking C. Interesting, they actually managed to get C. It's usually the team that has the better ranged pressure will be able to take C, but it looks like Nightmarish went straight for D point.
Yeah, so maybe perhaps they're kind of edging the potential here, but look at this damage already happening onto the opposite Bloomer, having it, and they have a very easy escape route.
Strip back, they've got the Cyclops wall, and their Woo is low, and Nightmarish's Woo is quite low.
Yeah, Taito's sticking in a little longer, but he'll probably get out very, very easily. And they're just going back and forth. Look at this Woo, he can barely even escape in his own territory.
And the Woo goes down.
And moving in, Margaret trying to cover for him, but now he's back. And this Taito, just applying pressure, he's half, but look how evasive he is. Getting chunked a little bit. Jump pad gets him out, fully out. Look at this. They were on they were on that wall for so long and applying pressure, and they just recover.
You know, I mean, once you have C point, you can access that really easy and prevent enemies from, obviously, getting back to you, which is what you want. This map is all about being able, since the rotations are so long, you have to plan so early in advance before you do it.
Yep. It looks like right now Nightmarish is wanting to position possibly to go for E, but then they turn back. I think they're probably afraid of the potential back.
They're going in for E,
which is smart. They're going in for B right now.
And it looks like Nightmarish is trying to defend this. It's working right now. It worked last time. But the problem is, if they don't manage to interrupt Soggy Ballers' point, Soggy Ballers are just going to get that 20 power. And if they interrupt... Oh, they're not going to interrupt. Interesting. Okay, now it comes down to the 90-80 situation.
Yeah, so right now, if nothing happens, technically Soggy Ballers would get this push because they're ahead by 10. So long as no one goes over and interrupts. But right now, it looks like Taito is positioning possibly to try and get back there.
They're dragging them off of... Yeah, he's dragging them off of E point or B point. That's what he's doing.
No, they're actually turning back around. This is a mistake, in my opinion. They're
just going to have to get a kill. And they don't get it. How do you misplay that?
That was...
Okay, it's fine.
It was an interesting choice. That was... I'm not entirely sure what happened. I feel like Soggy Ballers had that in the bag, and then all of a sudden, you see this pressure here. Soggy Ballers just keeping them in their base despite them getting the push. Look at this pressure. They can't go in and chase this. It looks like Trip wants to. Nice kick on the T-Mat, but she's got her escape.
T-Mat gets out and the Trip's gonna go down.
She gets immediately launched and focused. There's nothing she could have done there. She's gonna need to invest super early in that escape CCE talent if she keeps getting jumped on like that. But look at this, just the impact damage doing about half to the first wound, and now we just have full control of C yet again. You know, Soggy Baller is happy to just kind of wait. They didn't get the first push, but they still have the priority point. Taito dancing around, doing a little bit of damage over to Mosey, rather, I should say.
Is a fight going on a D point? Oh, they're trying to take D. Okay.
Margaret, wait, nice hold up.
Do they go for the double summon is the question. I feel like they should.
Lots of damage coming through on both sides, but no kills.
Black Pixel's gonna die. He's low. Black Pixel goes down to Trilogy.
And despite the entirety of that skirmish back and forth, only one kill happening. Taito finding Mozu finding a kill on the Taito. I believe Taito might have been trying to find a little bit of damage there. And we also see a pickup kill in the favor of Soggy Ballers, now ahead by 10 as the fight's continuing.
Soggy
Ballers is low,
there's Sven, may go down here. The Gnosis Focus is gonna come out.
Margrave just needing to back up right now. He's trying to deflect, do a little bit of damage.
Sandy Focus comes out. That might give them time to keep fighting. Their members of Soggy Ballers are low, though.
Yeah. Nightmarish also, I mean, both teams right now having some low health heroes. They need to kind of take these fights carefully. Margrave does fall, sticking a little too long, getting peppered down by T-Mat. And they return a kill. Still only ahead by 10 for Soggy Ballers. Rotations coming through.
Putting in so much effort into these fights, but they're getting very minimal reward with what they're putting in.
Nice interrupt to the summon, but it's only going to delay for a moment. They're trying to reposition here. I do think that they want to try for the double side cap, like you said. Fight coming through. Zendora about half. She does have to escape. She's got plenty of ability to do so.
There's going to be a kill from Black Pixel onto the T-Mat and 100 power, 40 power difference.
Yep.
Man.
This is a much bigger push, much more damage done on the impact. And Soggy Ballers already moved in to attack this.
Yeah, they're already in a position to get it.
Doing super well.
They're using the T-Mat focus on that?
It does seem like an interesting choice, but with two people dead, I don't think that they can really defend this. Nightmare is struggling just to hold their own ground. Big damage coming through. That first one is going to go down no problem. Now they have to get out.
Oh my. Oh, Ezra might go down. Ezra, come on.
She's got no stamina. Trip's still on her. The team is helping.
Oh, nice launch. There's no way. And she lives. Oh my god.
The launch of the Nos is coming in clutch. Trying to find a little bit of repentance here, low health heroes on the side.
20 power up? Ooh. And they must have, can't see how much power Soggy Ballers has, but I think that Trip did give them 10.
Yeah, this is actually confusing, because Trip went down, but for some reason the power went to, oh, we just don't see Soggy Ballers' power right now.
Power? Yeah.
Yeah.
They look like they have,
I think they have 40. I think it's even.
I think they have 40. I think it's even.
Right now, Nos is.
Black Pixel might go down. Black Pixel might go down. No way he gets out. Black Pixel lives. Oh my god. Taito, that. The Taito tech? Do not sleep on it.
It's. No, definitely not. I mean, right now we're seeing that Soggy Ballers is doing super well at just staying together and covering each other when they need to escape. So many clutch moments where they've just saved each other through CC, through body blocking. I mean, I can every I can count a number of times now already where I've seen it looked like someone should die on Soggy Baller's side and then they just on Soggy Baller's side and they just don't.
Big fight happening here. The running thing close is what you want to do. The Margrave gets low. They're all Chaos Quaff comes out. Looks like they're gonna back up. They have. Soggy Ballers are choosing to fight with D as their point, with the Kai going down. Who got the rampage?
I'm not sure.
I think it's Soggy Ballers.
I think Soggy Ballers did somehow find 100 power somewhere in the end. So yeah, Soggy Ballers having the invisible 100 power push. We also don't see the impact obelisk. Damage that it does. I don't mind an obelisk.
On your own point?
I mean, if you're going to control both sides, why not, right? You know, if you're going to get punished for not being able to hold both sides, might as well not get power.
These guys are clowns. I knew they would do stuff like this. I knew.
I don't mind the obelisk on this side. They were positioning
I feel like
here.
It can work. It's just such a random thing to do.
It is.
I mean, for the double summon, I kind of understand it. Just because you're not going to... If they go for that, they're not going to give power. You're almost directing them to C point.
Margraven's Endora finding a little bit of a flank here, chasing out their ranged damage dealers. They're completely gone from this fight, but now they're being focused in.
Oh, the trap. The focus comes out. This might be over for them. The Margrave's getting low. So Simply Mary. The focus comes out. Simply Mary gets the kill on the Margrave. And Simply Mary still... Look, they get the kill on the trip as well. And the Woo goes down as well. 30 power to zero for Soggy Ballers.
Soggy Ballers,
and now they're just
going
to push
kills.
Into B.
Yep, they're going in to push onto this creature, take advantage while they can. Nightmarish has respawned, but it will take a little bit of time before they actually get there to respond to this. And it's melting. They're doing their best to pepper the damage, but they've got the AoE boost from Gnossus. Chip going in right again, trying to find a pick, but she's learned her lesson now at this point. She...
Don't have to back up, though. Their main engage is kind of low, which is the thing. That's the one thing about Soggy Ballers comp that's kind of rough. They only have one main engage who isn't the best at doing so, which is kind of bad for them, especially because Gnossus fails when he's CC'd.
Yeah.
And most of the people on Nightmarish have strong CC.
That's very true, but at the same time, you could argue right now, it doesn't seem like Nightmarish is utilizing it to the best potential. They're doing damage. They're getting this Bloomer yet again, already at half. They only just arrived. Wu trying to do some damage over here, but he can't quite land some attacks. Nice pull on the team map, but she's got an escape. Margrave Leap getting out of there, and yet again, Soggy Ballers just holding this point. C will capture, grant them this power. Not quite an auto wound, but super close.
Again. However, Nightmarish do have control of D now, which if they can, I feel like Soggy Ballers' main goal right now should be to defend C, because when Clash comes around, that's going to be huge for them.
Yep. And if they don't get this wound right now, it will not be Clash yet, so they need to dedicate for it. Gnossus is in.
There he is going for wound, yep. And Clash... Oh, they get the kill, but Clash is going to happen.
Clash
yep.
will begin.
We're just seeing it again, same as last game. Like, Soggy Ballers are just always going to be a step ahead from them.
Soggy Ballers finding a kill on the back foot here as we transition to Clash. A little bit of a fight between two assassins right now. Wu is super low, but he's getting the resets. He's
because
surviving.
He turned around on Taito.
Taito
oh
can't...
my god. Taito lives.
The bull hits, but...
Taito dies! Oh my goodness.
That was insane. I cannot believe Wu turned that around. Good support from his Mozu. And they need to get back in. And luckily, they are on their side right now. But right now, it seems Soggy Ballers has regrouped. They have control of C. And, I mean, honestly...
They're fighting over B point. That's where the power is. That's the thing, though. Now that they have C, they can just sit up here and use that hallway as their where they're gonna fight. This is their point. So the only way that Nightmarish can win right now is to get C point.
Big death ray, nice damage coming out of Nightmarish. Actually finding a little bit of potential here. The creature is not quite dead yet, but they technically won that fight.
Well, I mean, the 30 power up, and which was. But the thing was that they were 30 power up, but they didn't manage to get C point.
Not quite yet, but they just need one kill and
they
do find it. 100
to 60?
This actually looks like a potential possible comeback option for Nightmarish right now. They don't have control of C, as you said, but they're showing signs of life. Going a little bit far.
All of Soggy Ballers is low right now. This is not a good position to be in.
Drake was resummoned. or rather a Drake was summoned to get control of this point again. Nightmarish just taking the auto wound and have to reposition now to try to fight for C yet again. But having a sieging monster is going to make this a lot harder. A little bit of a scuffle happening here in the middle point. Tiamat, of course, applying pressure from a distance, trying to keep them in combat. Nice little pick potential here.
Are using the door? The trip might get away, yet the trip has invis. She definitely gets away. She does escape.
Taito trying to find the kill, but not able to really
massive
see her.
Massive fight in the middle of the map.
We don't
did not
see
expect
this
to see this at all.
Yeah, we don't see this happen very often.
Black Pixel gets out with a slither of health. Thank God the team out there to save him. That woo would have got him there.
Nice little use of the Infernal Portal there to kind of get back into the point, though I feel like it's not entirely, like, super useful on that point.
I hate that.
But
I hate that. I hate Infernals on this part of the map, like, in general. Like, Flash is not a good place for them.
Nice jump pad up back into the point. Good back to control.
Huge fight going on at C point. Look, their Margaret is
focus.
Low, however. Massive car focus as well. Melon's 1 HP might go down to the... Nope, lives because she spam.
Nice Wu trying to jump in, but he's getting healed by the Bloomer now. Enough damage is
not... And
the not...
Wu goes down.
The Healing Waters comes clutch just in time to keep him alive. And yet again, Soggy Ballers. That says Sogger Ballers. That's hilarious. Soggy Ballers. I didn't even notice that until just now. But anyway, Soggy Ballers still in full control of D point, despite Nightmarish, you know, sometimes finding these fights, they can't fully commit. Fights still end up being even. And back.
And Soggy Ballers get that. We don't see how much impact damage it is, but I reckon that's almost half of the bar.
Yeah. Maybe a little bit less. And do you think that do you think Soggy Ballers might go for the end here?
Go for it. Go for it.
They do need to get healthy right now. They're still fighting. We'll see. Layering getting pinned down here. About
a little bit over half?
About a quarter or third, I would say.
Quarter or third.
Oh, Nossus
can't
commit.
Somebody goes in, but immediately leaves.
Nope. He knows that he can't fully commit to that. He would just die immediately, which isn't the worst thing to happen during the rampage. Sven here a little bit low, but he probably still has his jump pad to get out in case he needs to. Trip coming in for the kick, but she's a little far forward, and she's not going to commit to it. She doesn't. She remembers last time she couldn't confirm that kill, and the full enemy team was there to help protect, make sure that their Sven gets out. So they didn't commit. They actually hardly did any damage, it seems like, to that wound. And now
they have the opportunity to.
Once again, repositioning to go for the C point where fights are happening.
Grip focus gets missed, unfortunately.
Chip is currently invisible. They actually did a lot of damage to that that Drake back there, but
Trip's
they're losing the fight.
Down. Black Pixel, nice finish there from the Taito. Ezreal uses focus here to try and kill. They're already 20 power up, but they want to kill this B point.
They do, and they do end up killing it.
They trade for the 20 power. Simply Marys goes down, but Ezra manages to get the Bloomer. They're still 20 up. Ezra gets the
going in. Nice
start, Sven, a little bit.
Sven a little bit low, but he's still super.
They need
able
to keep
to get
going.
There.
They have to keep going here.
The creature needs to get destroyed and perhaps summoned so they can get it on there. But nice Taito flank keeping them in combat. Now the health bars of Nightmarish are super low yet again. And they recover.
And the Margrave goes down to the Tiamat missiles and nerf that character, please.
Further nerf. Tiamat just applying a lot of damage. They've already resummoned C yet again. It does look like a Cyclops this time. So not a siege monster, but a little more defensive. Potentially, you know, locking the entrance for flanking maneuvers. And, well, they really just have to wait for this to capture. They have to go in now or it's going to be
a push.
That's all
they're going to do. Yep. They are looks like they're going to go for it. I don't think they get it in time. They don't.
Nope. So another big point of impact damage here. Definitely for sure they will probably go for this one. Soggy Ballers will need to pull off a miracle defense. Let's see if they can do it. Margrave's super low.
I think Soggy Ballers might have this. The creatures are low, so even if they don't get this, they can immediately push B and get that 10 power lead.
Not quite as much
as
it was.
Not as low as it said it was.
but they're already in here. The Moe's only person alive is Mozu. There is no chance. And that is going to be
the set.
The
for them,
set for them. Yeah.
There we go. Man, that was some good. I actually enjoyed watching those. Those were the comps were whack, but it was fun to watch.
Look at how much damage both of these teammates did. Around 62, 68,000.
This Andorra outhealed this fam
again.